Hi everyone, my name is Raman Kalyan. I'm on the Microsoft 365 product marketing team, and I'm here today with Mavi from our CXE team in engineering.
Yes, hi Raman, how are you?
I'm doing great, Mavi. How are you doing?
Very good, thank you for having me here.
Yeah, I'm excited to talk to you today about insider risk.
This is an exciting topic, I have to say. It's on top of mind for everyone right now.
Yeah, it is. I know a lot of companies recently, have started thinking about insider risk at the same level as they think about external risk, right?
Yes. You know, external risks have always been the top of mind for companies, but now, specifically during, to COVID and everything, and with the new normal that everyone's working from home. So the insider risk threat has become more obvious. Mm-hmm. And when we say insider risk, when we mean for employees, full-time employees, vendors, partners, everyone who has access to your organizational data, they can be a potential risk whether they intend to or not. You know, it can be someone who maliciously sabotage data. It can be an employee that just had a bad performance review. Right. And it could be someone who does it just, unintentionally, install malware or oversharing files from his SharePoint externally, et cetera.
And that can happen, especially nowadays with COVID and you're working from home, you're distracted, your kids are there or whatever, your dog's knocking at the door.
Yeah.
So all kinds of distractions are happening. And then people end up doing things that they may not intend to do.
Yeah, and that's why companies want to ensure that, the right data leaves the organization and the wrong data, the one that they need to keep secured actually stays in the organization and shared with the right people.
Right. Yes. And you've spoken to a lot of organizations as part of the CXE team, right? That's essentially what you all do.
Mm-hmm.
And what's your role there in terms of helping these organizations with Microsoft 365 products?
So the CXE team is a team that is spread worldwide, all the way from Australia, India, Europe, and obviously here in the US. And we help customers deploy our Microsoft 365 security and compliance product. Mm. We help them understand the benefits of the products and think of us as the voice of the customer within engineering. We help prioritize bugs, feature requests. We help shaping the product, to benefit the customer's use cases and scenario and protect their most sensitive data.
Yeah, no, that's awesome. And so in your role and in your team's role, as you've spoken to customers about insider risk, how are they approaching that problem today?
So companies are looking today for more mature programs because what we have today is more of a fractured solution. We have companies trying to integrate between user analytics solutions and user behavior solution. Mm. And it requires a lot of engineering resources. It requires a lot of analytics. It requires a lot of effort from the company, as well as it reduces a lot of false positives because you can never really tell what is going on in the company.
Right.
And they're looking for something that will also help them with an end-to-end solution.
Yeah.
That means from the moment you identify the risk until you analyze it, understand if that's a real risk or not, and how you escalate it and handle it, whether you need to go to HR or to legal or just, to this specific employee's manager.
Yeah.
And they need something that will connect all the dots all the way. And currently, there is nothing that basically in the market that helps that.
Yeah, okay. I mean, as I've spoken to customers, they've tried to use things like a SIEM system to try to address this, but the challenge with that is you have a lot of these configuration scripts, you try to ingest these signals into the product, and it takes a lot of engineering resources. And oftentimes, once you've even, written those scripts, if something changes, then the script breaks, you gotta go rewrite it, and there's a lot of maintenance, right?
And not only that, eventually these engineers find that they're doing a repetitive work over and over again, and then they get, sloppy. Because, I've seen that before, and they cannot identify sentiments or trends, within specific user or even a group in the company.
Yeah, another thing that customers have tried to attempt to use, or at least the first thing that they turn to is DLP.
Yes, but you need to differentiate between DLP and insider risk. Think of DLP as something that is real time, that can prevent a user from copying, from printing, et cetera. While in insider risk, we're thinking about a long-term solution, more right. of, you know, identifying trends, sentiments, and we look at this historically, mm-hmm. like it, you know, over weeks, days, months, and we can identify, you know, whether a user is being upset or just, you know, download something that is personal. We know how to identify that. With DLP, it's more of a real time here and now.
Right.
So it's not the same as insider risk. You can obviously combine between the two solutions. And today with insider risk, we know how to read the endpoint DLP signals, for mm-hmm. example. Mm-hmm. So we know how to actually add them into our analytics and analyze all the trends of that user.
Right. And just a minute ago, you talked about end-to-end approach. And so I think one of the end-to-end pieces that is typically missing from all of these different solutions is that interaction with like HR and legal, that in that collaborative investigative approach, right?
Yes. So when a company identifies an insider risk, an insider employee that, you know, causes something, right? They want to understand what to do with it. And they need to turn into HR or to legal and escalate that process, you know, to start an investigation. And what we're doing with Insider Risk is we're basically supplying them with all the platform and the tools that they can do that. First of all, we keep on the, you know, the employee's dignity because everything is anonymized. Mm. And HR and legal are involved, but then automatically we create like what we call private Teams channel for everyone to collaborate on that. And they investigate the case, and if needed, you know, they can take actions or just close the case.
Yeah.
But everything is kept in one place.
Yeah, and that's important from like a regulatory requirements or privacy perspective, right?
Yes.
So as you think about that, you know, even the insider risk management solution has pseudo-anonymization built in.
Yes.
To the product such that the names are anonymized and you can't see who it is unless you have the right permission.
Exactly. So that prevents biased, mm-hmm. you know, that's super important in companies like that.
Right. And one of the things, you know, I'd love to talk about next is the new innovations that we've delivered, the new innovations to insider risk management as a product.
Yeah.
Because there's been a lot of, you know, a lot of customers have been trying the product and we've gotten a lot of feedback and we've incorporated that feedback into the product itself. So I'd love to speak to that.
So as I said, you know, being the customer voice within engineering helped us shape the product. And now basically insider risk is as easy as 1, 2, 3. Let's take a look.
Definitely check out the other episodes that we have. And there are a number of resource links below. So take a look at those when you get a chance.